My name is Professor Michio Kaku. I'm a professor of theoretical physics at the City College and the City University of New York. A wormhole is a gateway, a shortcut between two universes. It was first introduced by Einstein himself in 1935. Think of the looking glass of Alice. The looking glass of Alice allows you to put your hand through the looking glass and wind up on the other side of forever, into Wonderland. That looking glass is the wormhole, connecting the countryside of Oxford to this magical land called Wonderland. Well, black holes, we think, are spinning very rapidly. We see them in outer space with our telescopes, and we clock them, traveling at around 1,000,000 miles an hour around its axis. We think that these spinning black holes do not collapse to a dot. That's the old picture. That's wrong. They collapse to a ring. A rotating ring of neutrons, rotating very rapidly, so rapidly it doesn't collapse onto itself. And if you put your hand through the ring, you do not die. You wind up on the other side of forever. No one has ever fallen into a black hole, so we can't test the theory. It is a theory. It hasn't been experimentally verified yet. But the theory does say that you don't necessarily die when you go through a black hole, that there's a finite probability that you can go through it and perhaps go to a different point in space and time. The catch is that to build a time machine, to build a wormhole machine, to take you to a different point in space and time, requires the energy of a black hole. You would have to have enormous energy comparable to that of a black hole to open up the gateway. And then you need negative matter and negative energy to stabilize it, which is even more exotic. So don't think that any household inventor is going to create a time machine in their basement. It doesn't work that way. We're talking about a very advanced civilization that has the capability of creating a wormhole backwards in time, or perhaps maybe to another galaxy. When you go backwards in time, the timeline forks, splits into two timelines. So Einstein said that time is a river. A river that speeds up and slows down, that meanders its way across the universe. The new thinking is that the river of time can fork into two quantum universes. So if you go backwards in time to save Abraham Lincoln from being assassinated at the Ford Theater, you've saved somebody else's Abraham Lincoln. Your Abraham Lincoln died at the Ford Theater.